Calgary Flames training camp coverage powered by TELUS. Brendan Parker, Peter Loubardias alongside, and good to have you back, my friend.
Great to be back.
That was fun to watch a hockey game here tonight. It had a real, well, it was a game-like feel. That was the intention from the coaching staff and the management staff. You only get two of these, tonight and Monday, to prepare for the season opener on January the 14th. What did you get in terms of preparation from tonight?
I like the pace. I like some of the combinations. I thought there was some outstanding individual efforts that we'll get into more in just a few minutes. And the other thing for me that's been a big takeaway, not only tonight in the camp, but some of the players who aren't going to be on the opening night roster, but whether it's Ruzicka or Godden or Phillips or, you know, a player like Connor Mackey, a lot of players' parks aren't very far away. Like, they're inching closer to making these decisions even more difficult. That's encouraging to me.
Well, and that's one thing that has come up with the coaching staff, or at least on the Zoom calls, is that it's never more difficult for a younger player to make that impression because they don't have the exhibition games to do so. So a good start in your eyes for some of those players.
Yeah, I don't think there's any question. And, you know, Adam Ruzicka is one player in particular that I watched him a lot in the Ontario Hockey League, and inconsistency was a real bugaboo for him. Mm-hmm. But after he went from Sarnia to Sudbury and former Flame Corey Stillman coached him, and then the last year in Stockton, boy, I see some huge strides in Adam Ruzicka.
Well, he figured into some of the offense. So let's go through it, Peter, and take a look at the goals from tonight's hockey game. I should mention, by the way, I know game score doesn't necessarily figure in too much with an inter-squad game, but it was a 5-2 final in favor of Team McDonald. So here is what it looked like as far as the goal scoring. And in that first period, it was a pair of goals from Team McDonald. The first one comes from one of the newcomers, Joachim Nordstrom, who signs here as a free agent over the offseason.
Nordstrom moving in on the left side, a diving block attempt, and he beats Markstrom on the short side.
Now here back the other way is Team Iginla tying it up. This is a 3-on-2 and some nice work here and there. On cue is Adam Ruzicka, who sets up Emilio Pettersson.
Yeah, Pettersson, huge career at the University of Denver, and another player the Flames are very high on.
And then Team McDonald, before the end of that first period, Yusuf Alamaki, the point shot. And there is Sean Monahan in a spot we're very familiar with.
You leave Sean in that area with a little time and space, generally the red light comes on.
For sure, and at that point, it was Josh Levo alongside those two men. We'll talk a little bit more about that in just a moment. Here's Andrew Mangiapane. Had a chance to speak with him after the game. Talked about getting that goal-scoring touch, and that is a nice finish from number 88 there and a beautiful pass there by Backlund as well.
Yeah, what a great chip by Michael Backlund, and Mangiapane stronger, more confident than ever with a beautiful finish.
Now here's Josh Levo playing with Elias Lindholm and Matthew Tkachuk. They changed those lines up a little bit. Tkachuk scores there, and Team McDonald taking control a little bit, 3-2 at that point, and now another opportunity here for Rasmus Anderson.
Rasmus Anderson, I think, right on the precipice of exploding offensively, wrap around, thank you off a skate,
yeah.
Thank you off another skate,
yeah.
And in it went.
Got a little help, but it doesn't matter because he actually talked about knowing that there's a little bit more to the offensive side of his game there. Jumps up in the rush, nice finish for Rasmus Anderson, and then here to finish things off is another newcomer, Dominic Simone. And that'll finish it up, 5-2. So Simone, Levo, Nordstrom, all kinds of new faces figuring into some of the offense. Also some of the familiar faces in terms of regulars in this Calgary Flames lineup in Monahan and Tkachuk. Let's talk for a moment about Tkachuk, the latter, and Elias Lindholm. That is a new pairing, we'll say, because the winger on the other, third winger on that line has changed a couple of times throughout camp. But the standard is Lindholm and Tkachuk. And what could we see from that pairing and then eventually that trio this season?
Well, I'm glad you talked about pairings. And I think the most significant move in terms of additions and maybe a bit of a restructuring with your forward group is taking Elias Lindholm, putting him in the middle, playing him with Matthew Tkachuk. And I know it's only three periods of an inner squad game, but if tonight is any indication about some early chemistry, and no one should be surprised, they're both so intelligent, especially Lindholm, who played one total minute more than any other forward last season, plays everywhere. I liked a lot of what I saw from that pairing, regardless if it was Simone or Levo in the last two periods with the two of them.
And just quickly, I'll ask you, because we did see both combinations. Levo there started with Monahan and Gaudreau, but then spent quite a bit of time with Lindholm and Tkachuk as well. What do you hope to see out of, you know, maybe rotating Simone and Levo throughout training camp, and what could fit best there?
Well, Jeff Ward and the coaching staff talked this week, Brendan, about using the week. He said, why don't we take a look at some things? We'd kind of be cheating ourselves if we didn't. So I like the fact that you saw both of those wingers with those two lines. I thought Levo really started to look comfortable with Tkachuk and Lindholm, which, you know, spoke a lot about those two guys. But I like the upside with Josh Levo. I've been a fan of his going back to his time in the Ontario Hockey League. And right before he got hurt last year in Vancouver, he was having a great month of December. Simone, he's built like a fire plug. He skates. He gets in on the forecheck, plays with speed. You know, he demonstrated with Sidney Crosby he can play with good players. So I like those combinations when they sorted themselves out throughout the course of the night.
Just one last one for you before we let you go. I mean, we talk about condensed camp, and now we're one inter-squad game away and a week away from dropping the puck on regular season action. What is important in your eyes as we kind of look now to this latter half of training camp? Is it's going to go quick.
Every day matters.
Yeah.
And you want to get better every day and answer some questions each and every day, and you need reps. Mm-hmm. You need reps. You don't necessarily have a lot of game time. So every practice, every on-ice session, I know it's coach speak, but it matters.
Absolutely.
It's all about the preparation and getting ready for your next Thursday in Winnipeg.
And it's been echoed by every single player to a man, whether it's on our daily Zoom calls or post-game tonight as well. Appreciate the time. This has been a lot of fun, and back up in the booth on Monday night.
Always enjoy the living daylights out of it.
Absolutely.
Thanks for having me.
Peter Loubardias, and we should mention, by the way, the second and final inter-squad game will be streamed live on CalgaryFlames.com as well, so you can check out the action there. And we'll see if we can pull him back down out of the broadcast booth to chat a little bit about it after.
I'm not a hard sell. And I can be tricked.